Well, Congress leader and former member of parliament Sajjan Kumar was today sentenced to life in prison after the Delhi High Court found him guilty in the 1984 anti-Sikh riots today. This makes him the first senior Congress leader convicted for the riots. He has been told to surrender by the 31st of December. Nearly 3,000 people were killed when mobs led by Congress leaders targeted Sikhs after the assassination of then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi by her Sikh bodyguards on the 31st of October. The 73-year-old Sajjan Kumar has been found guilty of murder and conspiracy through his provocative speeches in the Rajnagar area of Delhi, following which, on the night of the 1st and 2nd of November 1984, five Sikhs were killed by mobs. The two-judge bench of the High Court said today that it's important to assure the victims that despite the challenges, truth will prevail. The judgment also clubs the 1984 anti-Sikh riots with the Gujarat 2002 riots. It says that the absence of genocide needs to be addressed in Indian law and notes that the 1984 massacre counts amongst crimes against humanity. The court says that it fits a familiar pattern of mass killings, which includes the 2002 Gujarat riots as well as the 2013 Muzaffarnagar riots. The court said the targeting of minorities, attacks spearheaded by dominant political actors, facilitated by law enforcement agencies, was common to all these mass crimes.
For many of us who were witnesses to what happened in Delhi and several parts of the country in 1984, it was perhaps the worst kind of genocide that we ever saw. Thousands of innocents were burnt and killed. The mobs were led all over by congressmen and congress leaders. The injustice of 1984 needs a closure. And it's only after these key people, important Congress leaders who had perpetuated that injustice, are convicted that the closure can ever come to an end.
कमलनाथ का सवाल है जिसके बारे में ये बात कर रहे हैं तो वही बात तो सेंटर में हो रही है आज कौन लोग बैठे हुए हैं लोग
सेंटर में तो टॉप पे बैठे हैं भाई जो राइट्स में इन्वॉल्व थे जिनकी रेख-रेख में हो रहा
है वो कैसे प्रधानमंत्री बने हुए हैं जांच तो होनी चाहिए ना पूरे तरीके से होनी चाहिए जो फैसला अदालत करती है वो फैसला अदालत करती है वो एक लीगल प्रोसेस है उसके ऊपर अगर अरुण जेटली जी बेबुनियाद किसी पे आरोप लगाएं तो हम भी कह सकते हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री जी कुछ आप भी
Well, joining us tonight, H.S. Phulka, senior lawyer, someone who has been tirelessly fighting for the victims of 1984 for many, many years now. Mr. Phulka joining us on the program this evening. Jarnail Singh, who's a senior journalist and writer and a survivor of the 1984 riots. His family was attacked back then when the riots happened. Manoj Mitta, journalist and author. Manoj has reported on and written extensively about 1984. We have Mr. K.T.S. Tulsi, senior advocate and Rajya Sabha MP. Affiliated to the Congress Party, and Mr. I.P. Singh of the BJP joining us from Lucknow tonight. Mr. Phulka, to you first, sir. What a day this must be for you, and I'm sure it's one where you have mixed feelings because you finally have the first conviction of a senior Congress leader, and yet it took 34 years to come to this point.
This is a big day, not only for me or for the victims, and I would say this is a big victory for the nation. The High Court has very clearly said and given a loud and clear message that those people who are in power and they commit these kind of crimes, thinking that they will get scot-free, they should forget about it. One day the law will catch up with them. I mean, this is relevant in the today's extent also, those people who are indulging into lynching and doing these kind of crimes, that one day will come, the law will catch up with you. I mean, if you have committed these crimes for some petty political gains, in your young age, then probably you have to spend your old days in jail. This is what happened to Sajjan Kumar. He was young, and now his old days, rest of his whole life, he has to spend in jail. So this is a big, big victory, and personally for me, because I had resigned even from the office of leader of opposition to appear in this case. And so I thank media also for all the support which media has been doing it, particularly the NDTV, in this struggle.
Mr. Phulka, as you said, it's actually a very important court judgment for many reasons. And one of the things the court has said, which you've alluded to, is how criminals have enjoyed political patronage, that the aftershock of these atrocities is still being felt. And that was in the context of how victims over the years have been intimidated, they have been harassed, that there has been an abject failure of the police to even register an FIR. The importance of this, are you saying, or you're suggesting just now, will go beyond this case and could possibly then, target other big fish of 1984?
That is true. This makes our case against Jagdish Tiger and against Kamal Nath very strong. This judgment and also the judgment which was delivered 2 weeks back by Delhi High Court, convicting 88 people, and both of these judgments has made our case against these two people also very strong.
All right. Well, we have Mr. Janel Singh here in the studio. Mr. Singh, what had happened with your family, and how? What are your thoughts today as you hear about this verdict 34 years later?
It has been source of deep anguish for the community. For last 34 years, it's been painful years for us. I remember I witnessed 1984 as I was 11 year old. My school was in the Gurdwara premises in Lajpat Nagar. When my school was burned, my Gurdwara was burnt alive. And my elder brother, Gurcharan Singh, he is polio stricken, he cannot walk. So even he was not spared. He was beaten brutally. And my mama's taxi stand was burned. I didn't lose anybody from my house, but I was hiding in the altar. My mother was so roughed up and slapped me. They were just trying to save us. So that sense of hopelessness never left me. I must say that it never left me. And then I became journalist and I wrote about 1984, and I was covering Rajya Sabha when this report, Nanavati Commission report, was tabled in the parliament. And when Dr. Manmohan Singh said, "I bow my head in shame," I was covering that. But unfortunately, they didn't file a charge sheet. In 2008, CBI gave clean chit to Jagdish Tiger, and they filed a closer report in the case of Sajjan Kumar, the same CBI. And 2009, you know, when I protested against that. And after that, the CBI filed a charge sheet in 2010. And then in 2013, within two to three years, they were convicted. It had changed its position. They convicted. Five people were convicted and he was acquitted, Sajjan Kumar. And then we challenged, and today he is convicted. I must say it's a historic day. Otherwise, we were feeling like Sikhs have no right in this country. We don't have right to justice in this country. There was a sense of hopelessness. Really, we really felt bad, like degraded citizens. Now, I must say that When we are talking about that the judgment has mentioned about 2002, about Muzaffar Nagar. Now the bill is pending in the parliament. 2004, there was a draft of anti-communal and ethnic violence law. It's been 15 years. It has not been tabled in the parliament when Manmohan Singh was in the government, and now BJP. So I must say it should stop somewhere. It's a high time when a political person like Sajjan Kumar, he has been convicted. Now it is a high time that it should be changed. It's a stern message for those who are using riots for their political benefits. I must say my stand is now vindicated.
Okay. Well, I want to ask Manoj, though. Manoj Mitta, certainly the fact that this is the first senior Congress leader, a former member of parliament, convicted today. I think Mr. Phulka and Janel Singh, in a sense, summing up why this is so momentous. And yet, it's also a travesty, isn't it, Manoj? Because we're looking at 34 years. There were four commissions, nine committees, two SITs that were formed over these 34 years to investigate 1984. And we finally got a conviction today of a senior leader. I mean, it's a bit of a bittersweet day, isn't it?
Yeah, just to appreciate, the odds that were stacked against this kind of conviction, let's recall that, the first case that was registered against Sajjan Kumar was in 1990, 6 years after the massacres. And that happened because of the kind of cover-up that was on, the political patronage that the High Court was referring to for this politically engineered violence. And that case was also extensively referred to in this judgment today, because when he was sought to be arrested, the CBI officers who went there ended up being detained in his house. That was a kind of farce that was played out, and it indicated the kind of political clout he wielded even when Congress was not in power in 1990. And also, to put today's verdict in perspective, let's recall that in the context of Gujarat 2002, in 2012, there was a conviction of a political leader, that was Maya Kodnani, who was a minister in Modi's government in Gujarat. And that unfortunately was overturned earlier this year in April 2018 by the Gujarat High Court. So that precedent proved to be short-lived. But the one that was set today promises to be an enduring one, because after all it was set by the High Court, and the 201-page judgment that we've been delivered with is of a very high quality. It is backed with rigorous reasoning and precedent.
Absolutely. And so, and if you look at the arguments that the judges, what the judges have said also about the need to define some a crime like genocide, etc., I think these are important questions then that our parliament and our political leadership faces on, you know, how to sort of define these crimes going forward. But Mr. Tulsi, can I ask you, the irony, as we've been saying all day, is that this has happened on a day when Mr. Kamal Nath has taken oath as Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh. He's very strongly hit back, saying that, look, there was never a case against me. There's no charge sheet. There's no FIR. There's no case. You know, why am I being targeted now? But the fact is that hasn't his oath taking today been overshadowed completely by this story? This cloud hangs over him.
Well, I don't know. Firstly, I would like to say that this is a day of victory of truth. This is the day of victory of justice. This is a day of the fruit bearing fruit, the hard work for all these decades of Mr. Phulka, Mr. Jarnail Singh, Mr. Mitta. Because, you see, there is a deadly nexus between the police and the politicians, and this deadly nexus destroys evidence. They do not register FIRs. They do not record the statements of the witnesses honestly, and whatever is recorded honestly by somebody by mistake is destroyed. And that is why it was virtually impossible to be able to get justice and get people in power, well connected, convicted. We'll have to find a way, because otherwise this nexus is like now the lynchings that are taking place. There's a victim who's been further victimized. When these witnesses from these places were going to the office of Ranganath Misra Commission, they were not allowed to enter. They were picked up. They were detained. They were taken somewhere and kept in illegal custody, and witnesses, out of fear of the police, they left the city. That is why the work became so much more difficult for Mr. Phulka to be able to speed up the justice. It is a matter of great relief that at long last there is some justice, and I want to thank the High Court and the judges.
But Mr. Tulsi, do you think that the Congress, as a party, needed to have taken a stronger stand against these leaders over the years who, you know, were, you know, accused, even if there hadn't been FIRs filed or cases filed? It's exactly what you said. Very often cases would not be filed and FIRs would not be registered because we knew about the sort of nexus between the police and the governments in power. So do you think that the Congress's big mistake over these years was to sort of elevate these leaders who whose roles had come under a shadow? I mean, Sajjan Kumar is still a member of the Congress party. He doesn't hold a post. But look, Mr. Kamal Nath, he's right. He doesn't have a case against him. But, you know, there are witnesses, you know, who say otherwise about his role. You know, there's Mr. Jagdish Taitler as well. Is that a political mistake that the Congress has made over the years? A big one.
No, it's not only by the Congress. It's the mistake of the nation. The entire nation, the ruling party, the opposition, the police forces, the civil service, this is collapse of the administration. So I don't think we need to score political points on this. But the truth must be established. We must have a justice system which will be able to take care of the nexus between the politicians and the police and virtually make it impossible to dispense justice. This is a very important thing, and I am still not satisfied because I think this was a case, the barbaric manner in which the killings took place deserved death sentence. And I think once the truth is established, they should be held to pay. Why Sajjan Kumar has not got death sentence is a matter of disappointment. But right. I only hope that the central government will file an appeal against this.
All right. So you're saying he deserves the death penalty.
For enhancement
okay.
of sentence.
You're saying he deserves the death penalty. Mr. IP Singh, to ask yes. you here about the other important
That's
aspect
right.
of the judgment. Today the High Court has talked about other riots as well. It's talked about 1984 and the familiar pattern of mass killings of Gujarat 2002, Mumbai 1993, Kandhamal 2008, Muzaffarnagar 2013. And it said that in all of these, there's been the targeting of minorities spearheaded by dominant political actors. Isme to Gujarat ka bhi zikr ho raha hai, IP Singh ji.
Dekhiye, lekin aaj ke 34 saal pehle jo massacre hua, pure desh mein 3400 Sikh samaj ke log mare gaye. Unke gale mein tire dalkar jalakar maar diya gaya. सवाल यह है कि सज्जन कुमार अभी भी कांग्रेस के सदस्य हैं, उन्हें आजीवन कारावास हुआ, यह एस्टैब्लिश हुआ कि कांग्रेस दोषी थी। कांग्रेस को इसके लिए मैं तो यह कहूंगा कि राहुल गांधी को राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष के पद से इस्तीफा देना चाहिए और जगदीश टाइटलर से लेकर कमलनाथ का जो नाम आया है उनके खिलाफ भी फास्ट ट्रैक पर ले जाकर उनके खिलाफ भी जो कुछ बनता है उन्हें भी सजा होनी चाहिए, वो दोषी हैं। और ये कांग्रेस उसके बाद भी 2004 में जगदीश टाइटलर और सज्जन कुमार को टिकट देती है और दोनों दिल्ली से सांसद बनते हैं, उन्हें बचाने का काम किया गया, बार बार कमेटी बनाई गई, कमीशंस बनाए गए, उस रिपोर्ट को दरकिनार किया गया और आज न्याय की जीत हुई है। तो इसलिए इस कांग्रेस दोषी है, इन लोगों को जितनी सख्त सजा मिलनी चाहिए वो दी जानी चाहिए और कहीं भी चाहे देश में किसी भी तरह का मामला हो, लेकिन ये मामला बिल्कुल डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ का है। और दिल्ली के अंदर जहां सरकार थी वहां सबसे ज्यादा लोग मारे गए, चिंता की ये बात थी कि कानून अपने हाथ में लेने का काम
लेकिन...
किया।
आईपी सिंह जी आप बिल्कुल ठीक कह रहे हैं, वो तो 1984 की बात है, लेकिन आईपी सिंह जी
एक एमएलए
आईपी सिंह जी ये बताइए कि जो कोर्ट ने बाकी रायट्स की भी बात करी है, चाहे वो कांधमाल हो, मुंबई हो, मुजफ्फरनगर हो, गुजरात 2002 की भी बात की गई है, जो उन्होंने कहा है कि इन हर रायट में एक कॉमनैलिटी है, आप माइनॉरिटीज को टारगेट करते हैं, पॉलिटिकल एक्टर्स जो हैं वो इसको लीड करते हैं, आप इसके बारे में क्या कहेंगे जो कोर्ट ने कहा है?
देखिए, कोर्ट का अपना वर्जन है, कोर्ट अपनी बात कहती है, लेकिन जो भी रायट हुए इतनी बड़ी संख्या में लोग नहीं मारे गए, जिस तरह से तुलसी जी ने कहा कि ये न्याय की जीत हुई है और लगातार लटकाया गया।
देखिए, संख्या से तो मेजर नहीं करना चाहिए ना आईपी सिंह जी, कि आपकी संख्या 500 ज्यादा थी, हमारी 500
बिल्कुल किया जाना चाहिए,
बिल्कुल नहीं,
क्योंकि ये
रायट
तक चलता रहा, कांग्रेस की हुकूमत पूरे देश में थी, जनरल सिंह जी को बचाने का
सवाल पूछना चाहते हैं आपसे, आईपी सिंह जी एक मिनट,
लेकिन आज भी
जनरल सिंह आपसे कुछ सवाल करना चाहते हैं।
आईपी सिंह जी मैं ये पूछना चाहता हूं कि क्या बीजेपी मोदी जी की सरकार है, क्या ये एंटी कम्युनल वायलेंस लॉ लेके आएगी, क्या ये एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन और पुलिस की जिम्मेदारी को फिक्स करने के लिए प्रोविजंस बनाएगी या नहीं, या हम सिर्फ ये कहते रहेंगे कि 2002 और 1984 के अंदर जो फुटबॉल बन जाए हम आगे भी देखें। क्या मोदी सरकार तैयार है कि एंटी कम्युनल एंड एथनिक वायलेंस लॉ जो बिल 2004 से पेंडिंग है, जो ड्राफ्ट बना था, वो लाया जाए और कम से कम ऐसे प्रावधान किए जाएं कि अगर किसी पुलिस अधिकारी के क्षेत्र में होता है और दो घंटे में उसको वहां पे कार्रवाई नहीं करता तो वो सस्पेंड हो जाएगा, अगर किसी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को डीएम है वो सस्पेंड हो जाएगा। क्योंकि मैं कह रहा हूं त्रिलोकपुरी में आपके एसएचओ शूरवीर त्यागी ने कत्लेआम कराया, 500 लोग उसने मरवाए, आपके सराय रोहिल्ला में पुलिस ने खुद गोलियां चलाई। कुसुम लत्ता मित्तल कमेटी रिपोर्ट कहती है कि 72 पुलिस अफसर जो हैं वो कलंक हैं पुलिस के नाम पर, उन पर कार्रवाई करें। लेकिन शर्मिंदगी की बात है कि जब शिवराज पाटिल होम मिनिस्टर थे, मुझे याद है मैं राज्यसभा कवर कर रहा था, तो बोले कि वो अब रिटायर हो गए, अब उनके खिलाफ कार्रवाई नहीं हो सकती।
आईपी सिंह जी तो शायद बोल नहीं पाएंगे कि उनकी सरकार क्या करेगी, दैट इज समथिंग आई डोंट थिंक विल बी इजी फॉर हिम टू आंसर, बट मिस्टर फूलका कैन यू टेल अस,
ये मामला अटल जी की सरकार में ही आया था, ये मामला अटल जी की सरकार में आया था, हमारी नीयत में कभी खोट नहीं था। कांग्रेस लटकाने भटकाने में विश्वास करती है, मैं समझता हूं कि आज का जो फैसला है, आज जिस तरह का कारवास हुआ है उसको देखते हुए हम पूरी उम्मीद करते हैं कि माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी और भारतीय जनता पार्टी सहानुभूतिपूर्वक इस पर विचार करेगी और आगे बढ़ेगी।
मिस्टर फूलका, दिस व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू आस्क मिस्टर आईपी सिंह अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट द कोर्ट हैज यू नो टॉक्ड अबाउट सेवरल रायट्स दैट हैव अनफॉर्चुनेटली डिफाइंड आवर कंट्री इन द लास्ट मेनी इयर्स, द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दिस अकॉर्डिंग टू यू एंड द फैक्ट दैट द कोर्ट इज सेइंग दैट the law needs to address this loophole about defining what genocide is. What are the implications of that, Mr. Phulka?
You see, one is that the law needs to be brought in. The other is that the guilty of the other riot should also need to be convicted. But the main thing which I have mentioned earlier also, this is a to check these kind of crimes happening and recurring again, this is a clear message by the court that the law will catch up with you, so you think twice before you indulge in these kind of crimes. That is a very clear and loud message, and I am quite hopeful that the Supreme Court will uphold this. And one thing more, like Mr. Tulsi said, there should be a death sentence. I feel that the life imprisonment up to his death, we are satisfied, at least I am. I have fought this case throughout. I am satisfied with this punishment, and I would not recommend filing the appeal on this, because Sajjan Kumar is filing the appeal. I would not advise the victims or the CBI also to file the appeal. We should be happy with the judgment, and we should fully support this judgment in the Supreme Court and should ask the Supreme Court to dismiss the appeal of Sajjan Kumar.
Manoj Mitta, what does this judgment mean, if anything, for the other big fish of 1984? I mean, as I said, Kamal Nath has consistently denied any role, talking about the fact that there's no case. What about him, though? And what about Jagdish Taitler and the shadow that hangs over them?
You know, the judgment also puts the focus on at least two prime ministers. One is Rajiv Gandhi, because he did not allow FIRs like the one that led to the conviction today to be filed. You know, Jagdish Kaur's FIR was never filed, was never registered in 1984 or the years that followed. And in 2005, when Nanavati Commission gave its report, you know, at that time, if you recall, the ATR, the Action Taken Report submitted by the Manmohan Singh government, actually rejected any follow-up action suggested by the commission against these leaders, including Sajjan Kumar and other leaders, Taitler and Kamal Nath, right? So had there not been protest against that ATR, had they not been forced by the opposition and civil society to overturn their decision, this judgment that we are seeing today would not have happened. It is because the Manmohan Singh government was forced to resile its stand and allow the follow-up action to take place that this Jagdish Kaur's case was taken up by the CBI in 2005, and we see the outcome of it. And similarly, there should have been action against Kamal Nath too, though unfortunately the Nanavati Commission gave him a clean chit, despite saying that the man was there on the spot. Two Sikhs were lying in a critical condition in his presence, and he did nothing to save them or to stop the police or the rioters from carrying on hostilities against
Sikhs. In a way, those
Sikhs.
Questions are going to keep and, haunting him.
He even went
if,
to the extent of saying
yeah,
that...
Yeah, I mean, that's going to keep haunting him even if there is no formal case.
Just hang on. Just let me complete this point, that the Nanavati Commission, in fact, even said that Kamal Nath's defense was vague.
Yeah,
was so despite finding his defense vague, it ended up giving him a clean chit in a very dubious manner. So this is something that is... Yeah.
Mr. Pulka, I just have one final question for you,
in
sir.
In the current context.
Are you going to be continuing to fight other cases? Because there are so many of them. In many of those cases, the victims have actually died. They're no longer around. Are there other cases that you are pursuing now?
Yes, there are other cases also which I am pursuing. And so there are many witnesses who are still alive, and they are prepared to give evidence. And so we will pursue. We will continue pursuing these cases. And as far as I am concerned, now we will try to get the case against Kamal Nath also registered. And we will... Now try that the charge sheet against Jagdish Tyagi is also filed. So we will continue with this struggle till the end. We'll take it to the logical end.
Well, Mr. Pulka, good luck to you in that fight. You've been fighting this, giving hope to the victims of 1984. Thank you for doing that, and thank you for joining us on the program this evening.